My topic today is computational mechanics. Actually, computational mechanics of microarchitectural solids and structures. But I start with a picture from the university campus. I still remember the feeling as a first-year student starting my studies in this lecture room. You can see in the picture. Somehow, not only the lecture room, but the whole campus of our university was able to create an uplifting atmosphere for our studies. But I think that one crucial part of the atmosphere was actually created by the list of things you can see written in the university law, speaking about the duties of a professor. The law speaks about research, teaching, science and art in general, and finally about societal and international activities. I try to include all of these aspects in my talk. What is interesting in the mechanics of solids? To me, it is the generality of mechanics. In civil engineering, we often deal with structures which are very large. But of course, structures are made of materials, and therefore we have to go to the very small scales as well, even up to the nanoscale. But the fundamental concepts of mechanics, they remain the same. Displacement, force, energy, and others. So finally, we can say that the playground of mechanics is quite large. Next, about solids and structures. In a student project, we needed to think about the safety of construction sites. You can consider a construction site of a tall building and a tall crane that accidentally drops something. And that something starts falling down towards the top floor, the new top floor of the building. In this computer simulation, a steel beam hits a concrete slab, which is reinforced by using steel bars. And it takes only milliseconds for the beam to break the slab, if the velocity is high enough. Inspired by another class of traditional structures, we move to a research topic of mine: microarchitectural solids and structures. What you see here in this picture is five beams made of one specific material. And the numbers, they seem to indicate the size of the beams. But if we zoom a bit closer, we can actually see that the material is an artificial material. We call it metamaterial. It's made of triangles by repeating little triangles, here shown by the gray area. And the numbers, they seem to indicate how many triangles we have in the thickness direction of the beam. This is crucial because the classical theories for homogeneous materials, they do not take into account this kind of microarchitecture of this kind of metamaterial. When developing non-classical theories, we have played a little bit with this kind of structural idea. With the beams, you can see in the middle, and with the plates and shells, you can see in the picture. And one benefit of this kind of structures is that they are quite strong, quite stiff, but still very light. keeping this kind of structures in mind, we move to computational mechanics. When analyzing these kind of structures, we try to avoid modeling every little detail of the microarchitecture. And we try to avoid making separate models which depend on the number of the triangles in the thickness direction. When developing general models, we have spent a lot of time on mathematical physics, numerical mathematics, and computer programming. These are the core activities of my team. Finally, I would like to show a picture of a lattice structure. These structures we have first modeled by using the standard computer-aided tools of design. And then, with our German and Italian colleagues, we have printed these structures by using a 3D printer using metal. And of course, finally, we would like to see that our theories follow the experiments what we are doing with the printed structures. With this kind of topics of research and teaching, including also some societal and international activities, I hope to create an uplifting atmosphere for the next generation students for their studies.